So in this video, we're going to try to explain the difference between a free-running set point and a set point that's a part of a batch routine, or a batching set point, we might say. So to set the scene here, what we have is a 1280. We've already got this set up as a 1,000-pound scale counting in 0.2-pound increments. We've got a relay rack with a single solid-state relay in place. I've got a red light here that's connected to a power supply. It's custom for providing 24 volts DC to this light so that it can come on. And our simulator is here. And I've already gone through and I've got everything wired up. And so we're going to take a look at the free running set point first. Now, the idea behind the free running, and sometimes you'll hear this referred to as a continuous set point. And the idea is that the set point parameters are always being evaluated. There is never a point where the set point is not being looked at in terms of satisfying the criteria that's been set. So let's go ahead and put a free running set point onto the 1280 and we can see how that behaves. So I'll start by getting into the menu here. I'll go into configuration. And then I'm going to come down to my digital I/O. I've got this light already pre-wired in to digital I/O number one. Now it's important to make sure that we tell our equipment that we're going to be using the digital I/O first. So I'm going to set that as an output. The reason we have to tell it to use the output first is so that it becomes available when we go into the set point menu. So I'm going to go ahead and switch over to the set point menu now. We see our batching mode is off because we're not going to use the batching right now. We're just going to do free running. So I'm going to go into my set point one that's selected, go to the target. We see that that is off. I'll hit the pencil. We'll just select a simple gross set point. We'll hit done. I'm going to set the value for 500 pounds. Hit done there. Then, under my digital I/O, I need to tell it which digital I/O is going to be affected once we reach that set point. So I'm going to choose my slot 0, which is the native I/Os to the CPU board. That's where I have that wired up. And I'm going to select output number one, and we see that that's available now. None of the others are available. Only ones we're going to see are the ones that we've pre-configured. So again, that's why we had to indicate that first. And we'll select done there. And that's it. That's all I need for a free running set point. We got a set point established with the value and we assign it to the I/O. Let's go ahead and save and exit. Now remember, the free running set point is always being evaluated. This was a 500 pound set point. It was set to trip higher. And so in this case, I have no weight on the display currently. And when I ask it to trip higher at 500 pounds, my expectation is that my light is going to come on once I exceed 500 pounds. So let's go ahead and adjust our simulator here a little bit. We'll bring it up. Now we're close to 500 pounds. I'm going to tweak it over the line and our light comes on. Now because it's constantly being evaluated, that 500 pound threshold, it's either on or it's off at that point. So if I drop below, it goes off. I come above, it's on, below, it's off. It is constantly being evaluated. There's never a point where it is being ignored. And so that's now important as we go into the batching set point, because we're going to apply the set point now as part of a routine. And so then it's only going to be looked at when the routine is actually running. So let's go ahead and make a few adjustments to this. We'll hop back in the menu, go into config. We'll come down to our set point menu. We're going to go ahead and turn our batching mode on. And we'll set it for manual restart. And that just means that somebody has to tell it when to go each time a routine is run. So select done there. Then what I'm going to do is for my first set point, I'm not going to change anything. We're going to leave this set at 500 pounds with digital I/O 1. to trip higher. But we're going to go ahead and make sure that even though we've turned on the batching mode, we need to make sure in our settings that this particular set point is to be included in the routine. So we're going to go ahead and turn that on here as well. And then there's one final thing we have to do to make this a batching set point, and that is going to be we need to have some sort of a way to start it. We have to tell it when to go. So I'm going to create a soft key here real quick that says batch start right there. And say done, and we'll save and exit. Turn my simulator back down. Again, this is a batching set point, so the criteria is only going to be evaluated when the set point routine is actually running. So think back to the free-running set point. So if I were to go over 500 pounds, this light would come on. But now it does not, because my batch routine is no longer running. So this the criteria is not being looked at anymore. So if I bring this back down again, we'll get back to zero here. I'm going to go ahead and start the routine, and it lets us know that the batch is running. Now you notice that the light came on right away. This is another very important difference between batching set points and free running set points. With a free running set point, it was told to trip higher. So it didn't come on until we tripped higher, and then it turned off when we were below. But as part of a batch routine, we're sort of expecting that there's some kind of equipment like a valve or a chute or something that we want to open up and dispense some kind of a product into a container. That's typically how this goes. So as part of a routine, when we start the batch, the tripping higher is the effect of turning off that which we're trying to operate. So in this case, the light is sort of signifying that for us. So we start the batch, oh, the chute opens up and it dispenses product, and we want to keep dispensing until we get to 500 pounds. So now, if I increase my weight and I get to that 500 pound threshold, the light goes off. Or in the case of a chute or some kind of thing that's opening up to dispense your product, that chute or that valve would close off and then no longer fill for your container. And so those are very important differences between the batching set point and the free running. So to recap, free running always being evaluated. Batching routine set points are only being evaluated while you're a part of the batch routine. When this went off, you may have noticed that it had said batch complete here. So if I drop down below, notice the light does not come back on. We had to set this as a manual restart. So we remove the container, we get back to a zero, and then we would start the routine once again. Now see, it says batch running down here. As soon as I go over my threshold, now it says batch complete, and it's over. And the second main difference is the difference in how the tripping works. It's kind of the opposite. In a free running set point, if I say trip higher, my relay does not energize until I go higher. As part of the batch routine, it energizes right away and then de-energizes after I've met the criteria for the set point.